Hello everyone, in previous video, I have introduced the method to conditionally format the blood pressure line chart with benchmark measures and calculated fields. In this video, I shall share a way on how to use a tachometer visual, a type of Power BI customer gauge visual, to understand the average blood pressure against its range benchmarks. As shown exemplified on screen, we have five ranges around the BP normal benchmark value. The green color area is the range between the 102% BP minimum benchmark and the 98% BP maximum benchmark. These two percentages are calculated according to the above range line adjusted percentage value. If the tachometer indicator falls in the green range, which means that the average BP of a measured person is fine, the left yellow color area is a range below the 102% BP minimum benchmark and above the 100% BP minimum benchmark. The light yellow color area is the range above the 98% BP maximum benchmark and below the 100% BP maximum benchmark. If the tachometer indicator fall in the yellow ranges, which means that the measured average blood pressure should be evaluated. The red color ranges have the same construction as yellow ranges. Left red range is below 100% BP minimum benchmark, right red range is above 100% BP maximum benchmark. If the tachometer indicator fall in the red ranges, which means that the measured person should get blood pressure MC treatments. In the report, we have involved the mentioned range 9 adjuster with what if parameter feature. With the parameter, we provide the readers a flexible way to adjust the color range size to judge the BP value according to the more latest realistic standard scenario. By the way, once again, a note here, my video is only for Power BI analytics skill development. Please do not take the result from this video as base for any medical diagnosis. In the video, we have applied the free download tachometer by E&A, which allows 7 ranges. Regarding the usage of a tachometer visual, I have attached the URL link in the reference section. In the tachometer visual, at the top of AND data to your visual, under value selection, in the enter box, we placed the average of BP and visual level, such as the average of the systolic number and the average of diastolic number. The average BP values are calculated by DAX aggregation functions such as average and all except according to selection of slicers. Regarding the calculation description, I have made one previous video. You may refer to the top right highlighted suggested video link. For the visual, we should have the three measures for the range's start value, target value, and end value. Also, we plant 5 ranges in the tachometer, thus we need additionally 4 measures for each start value of other 4 ranges, which are range 2, 3, 4, 5. Creating those measures is quite straightforward. We shall base on the existing 6 measures in sample file created in previous video. They are maximum, normal, and minimum of systolic and diastolic. If you have not watched my previous video, please refer to the top right highlighted suggested video link. Okay, let's get started. First, we may start to create the 7 measures without parameters to fill the tachometer. For example, first measure is the range 1 start value measure for systolic. On top ribbon, ensure that we are in the home tab. On right-hand side field bar, choose table for hosting measures. We are under Table 2 tab. Click New Measures icon. In DAX formula bar, type measure name as 98% of the systolic minimum, which should be the measure systolic minimum multiply 0.98. Then the measure for systolic range 2 start value, which is 100% of systolic minimum. Range 3 start value measure equals to systolic minimum multiply 1.02. Range 4 start value is a systolic maximum multiply 0.98. Range 5 start value measure is the measure of the systolic maximum. The target measure should be 100% of the systolic normal, i.e. the measure of the systolic normal. The range end value measure should be 102% of the systolic maximum. Let's place the 7 measures into the tachometer. Format the range 1 and range 5 with red color, range 2 and 4 with yellow color, range 3 with green color. Let's place the chart with the changes of some slicers. It works as expected. By the same way, we create and add the 7 measures for tachometer chart of a diastolic. Now it's time to add parameters into this 7 measures for the 2 tachometer charts. We shall use the what if parameters to replace each constant percentage number in those measures. Regarding the introductions of the Power BI what-if parameters, I have attached the related URL link in the reference section. With filling inputs, what-if parameters were generated a table automatically which contains two fields, increase and the increase value. Increased fields stores the generated increment from minimum input to the maximum input, where increase value contains only the DAX expression using the selected value function, which correlates to the location of the generated slicer. Okay, in the report on top ribbon, ensure that modeling is selected. Then click the new parameter arrow, choose numeric ranger, name the parameter, for example, ranger 9 adjuster. Choose decimal number for data type to apply the accuracy incrementals for generated increases. Enter 1.000 input for minimum, 1.040 for maximum. Enter the 0.002 for increment. Keep tick in for AND slicer to this page, please create. We see that we have a slider slicer pop up in report page. Also on the right-hand side bar, we see a table, range 9 adjuster created. Expand the table, and the two fields are listed. One is the range 9 adjuster, one is the range 9 adjuster value, which is a measure with a DAX function selected value. In data view, find the table, and we see the range 9 adjuster field, which has list from 1 to the 1.04 with increment 0.002. Let's change the data type to percentage with a decimal 1. Back to the report view, move the adjuster location to the value position 102%. Click tachometer chart for average systolic BP. Let's start to modify the existing 7 measures which are added in the chart. First one is the measure for start value, the 98% of the systolic minimum. Click it in top bar. Modify the name as the range start of systolic. replace the 98% by 2.000 minus 1.020. The 1.020 is the range 9 adjust value of the table range 9 adjust. To the measure of end value, 102% of systolic maximum, modify the name as end value of systolic. Replace the 1.02 by range 9 adjust value. To the measure of the target value, the 100% of the systolic normal, keep the name as it is. To the measure for range 2 start value, modify the measure name range 2 start of the systolic. To the measure for the range 3 start value, the 102% of the systolic minimum, name it as the range 3 start of systolic. Replace the 1.02 by range 9 adjust value. To the measure of range 4 start value, the 98% of the systolic maximum, name it as the range 4 start of systolic. Replace the 0.98 by 2.000 minus 1.020. The 1.020 should be the range 9 adjust value. To the measure range 5 start value, the 100% of the systolic maximum, name it as a range 5 start of systolic. Now changing on the measure expression. We have all 7 measures updated. Let's move the adjust indicator. We see the corresponding size changing for each ranger. Repeat the same steps to add the parameters into the existing measures in diastolic tachometer chart. Place the range 9 adjust slicer in proper position with the two charts. Make slide format to the slicer. Place the slicer to check the changes happened in two tachometer charts. By this phase, we have the two tachometer charts updated with parameters. Hope this video brings some helps to your projects. Thanks for your watching. If you like to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscriber button. See you in next video.